Twice?
No, he did.
Slight jumper.
Durant right around Chandler. Oh, call up! Durant swings past everybody for...
This is what it looks like to be one of the five greatest scorers in NBA history. But even Kevin Durant is scared of one man.
Likes going to his left, spins right. Oh man, Edwards around the double team. Got a look. Butter. And man, it picks him up. Nice what a hezzy. Nice slams on the brakes. Edwards!
Kevin Durant has a lot to prove in this series. After leaving OKC for Golden State, his legacy has never been the same. But if he could be by far the best player on this Suns team and lead them to a title at age 35, he could save his legacy. For Booker, he was only two games away from a title in 2021 and has been fighting to get back ever since. However, Anthony Edwards could not care less as he rose to the challenge in Game 1, only days after being blown out by these same Suns in their building. Early in the game, Edwards was struggling though as he turned the ball over four times in the first term and having to sit because of foul trouble. However, the experience of Kevin Durant shone through as he was shot out of a cannon, putting up 11 first quarter points as the Suns looked to be in control early. However, once Ant returned, everything changed as he looked like a man possessed. Even though he was getting zero foul calls, Edwards still put on a show. The third quarter was where the game really began. First, Durant opened up the term scoring 9 straight points, but he was quickly topped. As later in the term, the legacy of Anthony Edwards gained a new chapter as he took it right to Kevin Durant, scoring on 3 straight possessions while being guarded by Durant, capping off a 21-5 run by the Timberwolves, which effectively closed the door on Game 1. The Ant-Man finished the night with 33 points on 58% shooting. For the Suns, Booker had a bad game, only making 31% of his shots, finishing with only 18 points. While it was Durant who was forced to carry the scoring load, putting up 31-7 with a steal and a block on 64% shooting. Minnesota had great bench production though, as Naz Reid made 2 threes, while Nikhil Alexander-Walker had the best game of his life, having 18 points off the bench on 58% shooting with 4 steals, completely dominating the Suns' second unit. For Phoenix to stand a chance in the series, they can't play this bad again, and later I'll tell you who will win the series. For the Timberwolves, it all starts on the defensive side of the floor, ranking as the best defense in the league, holding teams to 105 points a night. With elite defensive players such as Rudy Gobert, Jaden McDaniels, and Alexander Walker, they are so hard to score on, but even guys like Ant and Cat can play solid defense too, giving the opposition no weak spot to attack. With great rotation, guys who are willing to dive for a loose ball and give up their body for a charge, Minnesota is a team who even on a bad shooting night can still win a basketball game. The defense has been elite all season long, but it's been the offense that has struggled sometimes, only scoring 113 points a game, which is 18th worst. At times, they rely too much on Edwards and Cat in isolation, and along with Rudy not being a good floor spacer, it makes it easier to send double teams to Anthony Edwards. However, if Ant is balling out of his mind, none of this will matter. But is that really sustainable over the course of a 7-game series? I'll tell you why it just might be and why the Suns may have already lost this series. We learned 3 key things from Game 1, and those are that Anthony Edwards isn't afraid of the moment, Kevin Durant will be back, and Minnesota's defense is not to be messed with. Anthony Edwards just carried his team to the most impressive victory of his career, as Minnesota's Big 3 has just proven why they aren't a fluky team, as they were absolutely dominant on both sides of the ball, putting up 125 points and holding the offensive powerhouse that is the Phoenix Suns to only 95. Because of the experience and otherworldly talent of Durant, the Suns will bounce back, even if they lose Game 2 and go down 2 games. For the Suns' Big 3 of Beal, Booker, and Durant, they will have at least 2 games of unconscious scoring, which should lead to wins. For the Timberwolves, though, the most important thing is to continue to play lockdown defense. If you let Grayson Allen or Eric Gordon get hot, they could be the difference in a series, both being elite 3-point shooters capable of shooting over 40%. The Suns have learned a valuable lesson about Minnesota's defense, and that is not to mess with it. You have to be aware of exactly what play you're running and not make any mistakes at all, because it will cost you. The Suns will need to cut back on the Beal Booker isolations, leaving that to Durant, as his shot is virtually impossible to contest. However, on the opening play of the game, Gobert was switched onto Durant, which led to a tough shot and a miss. As if Durant gets particularly hot in a game, you could throw a different look at him, as Kat just isn't a good enough defender to make him shoot a tough shot consistently. For the Wolves to get past the Suns, this would be a legacy-defining moment in the career of Anthony Edwards. So far in his playoff career, Ant is yet to win a series, but his stats have certainly been good enough, averaging 28 points a game on 46% shooting. This is his best chance, as the Timberwolves haven't been this good since the early 2000s with prime Kevin Garnett. For me, if Ant scores more than 25 points a game and the others keep knocking down open threes, Minnesota will be in great shape. However, if the Suns' offense comes along, there isn't a team in this league that can withstand it. Defense is a much more consistent way to win a game, which is why I believe that the Timberwolves will win this series, likely in 6 or 7 games, as I do believe the Suns will come around at some point. If Minnesota gets stuck in a close game, though, that is where the Suns will thrive, as the clutch gene of Durant will be put on full display. But the Timberwolves' defense will likely win more games for Minnesota. But if the Timberwolves do beat the Suns, they will have to play the winner of the Nuggets-Lakers series. Either way, this is a more difficult series, especially if they draw Denver. The Nuggets are by far the favorites to beat the Lakers. However, in this video, I explain why the Lakers will win the series. But for the sake of this video, Denver wins the series. Minnesota could really prove to be a problematic matchup for the Nuggets, as their size and length on the defensive side of the floor could make the Nuggets uncomfortable on offense. This would be the ultimate matchup of offense versus defense. And as I said before, defense is a more consistent way to win games. But in this series, experience trumps everything. Fresh off of winning a title, the Nuggets definitely have the upper hand in the series, especially if they are able to maintain health. Nikola Jokic is having the best season of his career and will likely win the MVP, but the Nuggets are definitely not unbeatable. Minnesota have capable defenders all over the floor, and if we look at the playoff series between these two last year, I don't see the series being any less than 6 games. If Minnesota are going to win the series, they need to play the best defense of their lives, doing their very best to contain the playmaker of Jokic, while also making sure to stay home on the elite perimeter shooters such as KCP and Michael Porter Jr. However, that's not all, as you're also going to need to shut down Jamal Murray's offense, as come playoff time, he's a different beast. Anthony Edwards would likely draw this matchup due to his quickness, while actually being an underrated defender. But even that isn't all, as you're going to have to keep Aaron Gordon out of the paint, which will likely be the job of Karl Anthony Towns. As silly as this may sound, you may have to face guard this man, even though he isn't a threat from the perimeter, as his chemistry of Jokic on those alley-oop passes can really be backbreakers. For me, if the Timberwolves can play a perfect defensive game, they should win in 6 or 7. But if we're being realistic, I think the championship experience of Denver is just going to be too much for these young Minnesota Timberwolves, as I would say the Nuggets likely winning in 6 games. That's my take though. Who do you have winning the Suns series? And if Minnesota can win, can they go on to beat Denver? Let me know in the comments below.